Hi, Kevin.
Thank you. God! Oh! Oh, Jesus God! Oh, Mary, Mother of Jesus! Jesus of Nazareth!
What do you mean?
What do you mean? Wait, I thought this was a complete The Thing theme. It's not, it's villains. Hello, everybody.
Welcome back to the Doodle Stream, where every Friday, except when it doesn't happen, we spend a couple hours together, and I attempt to doodle out your ideas and suggestions from the chat. I pick the theme, and you pitch the ideas. Before we dive into all of the fun for today, did you guys know I have a Kickstarter running right now? Exclamation point book in the chat. I got my first, thank you, Bubble of O. I was in the middle of, you beat me, I was in the middle of typing it. It's my first art book. So this is, the first time I'm running a Kickstarter project in which I am at the helm of the project. I have not saddled up to Brian's project. I have not saddled up to the Autocracy account for their project. This is me. This is Kevin's project. This is all on me. And we are looking pretty good. I think we're 65% funded. So obviously we're not there yet, but obviously there's a lot of time. So if you haven't supported it, please consider supporting it. I know there's some folks that actually are hesitant to support a particular Kickstarter project because they want to make sure it gets funded before they support it, which is kind of nonsensical because it doesn't get funded unless you support it. So it's like, I'm not going to support it until it gets funded, but it only gets funded if you support it. It's like a weird chicken and egg thing, but I know that's a thing. So, hey, what's up, Jeff? Give Kevin all the money. Well, you don't need to give all of the money, but please check it out. The link is in the chat. Thank you, Bubble of O, for throwing that in. Still looking to get it funded. There are some really cool stretch goals with some like specific merch and things I've kind of wanted to do, but it's a lot of financial commitment and like stock commitment, and so this is really the only way that's going to happen. So if it doesn't happen through this, it most likely won't happen. So you know, stuff like lanyards and acrylic keychains and things. But also, I just want the book to happen. The book would be really cool. So this is a book of all of my live streaming doodles from 2019 to the halfway point of this year, 2022. It's the first 100 episodes of the show. Definitely more than 1,000 doodles in the book. I don't know exactly how many it will be in the end, but it will be more than 1,000. So check it out if you haven't already. I really appreciate it. And share it on social media if you haven't too. It really helps. It makes a big difference. I'm doing all I can. I'm trying to push from every angle. So thank you guys very much for considering it, for looking at it. So that out of the way, on the off chance you have no idea where you are, how did you get here? My name's Kevin, I'm an artist, I draw things, and that's what we're gonna do. We're gonna draw stuff together. If you're not already following me, you can find me on all the socials, exclamation point socials in the chat. I'm on all the places, same username. Post every day, although it looks like I'm gonna be moving to posting twice a day every day because according to my research, I'm not active enough. I'm not active enough on social media. Posting every day for 2 years, I'm not active enough. So, maybe we'll get into that later. So today is all about villains. The folks that support me over on Patreon, incredibly awesome people. They help keep things going. They keep the lights on, they keep the bills paid, they keep the food on the table. They get to pick themes for this show, and this week's theme is villains, which was suggested by Joseph M. Zawada, also goes by Farron Mox, I think there's an S on it. He might pop in. Probably not. I know he's having a great time at Brick Fair right now, so he probably won't. But I did reach out to him ahead of time to see if he had something in mind he wanted, and he did. So we're going to do that first, and then I'm going to start taking your suggestions and your ideas. So if you're not familiar with how it works, there's a suggestion box down below. If you're on mobile, you just click up in like the little the emoji thing in the chat. excuse me, in the chat, where there should be a little orange box for the suggestion box. If you're on desktop, a little easier to find over in the About Us section. So you can type that at any time, and I will bring it up as soon as I finish what Joseph Zawada wanted. And he wanted Yubaba from Spirited Away. So that's what we're going to do first. And hello to everybody who's here. I thank you guys so much for hanging out with me. Hello, Nick Lands. Hello, Hawkeye Lego Man. Funny Figs, Boba Laveau, Jeff, all of you guys are super awesome. Thank you so much. Ray says, I know a lot of folks doing Kickstarters who post 3 or 4 times. Yeah. Oh, I know, Ray. I know, Ray. I know, Ray. It's amazing. It's absolutely astonishing. So is Yubaba, is she the, like, old lady witch? Right? Or no? Yep, okay, that's what I thought, but I thought maybe perhaps. Perhaps I'd be wrong. Okay, that's what we're gonna do first. We're gonna do that first. But if you've got ideas, throw them in the chat. They will be next. And I hope everybody's doing wonderful today on this Friday. About to head into the weekend. Let's see, Bo Laveau says, what? Not someone from Bayonetta? I am surprised. I'm a little surprised as well. Thank you, Jeff! Exclamation point book. Oh, you're in Montana right now. Wild. Wild. Thanks for popping in. Especially if you're traveling. So this is my first drawing of the day. You guys know how that goes. Let's see how well this is. Could be awful. Could be okay. Could be awful. Today has been a day of chores and errands for me. I normally do that on Saturday, but I've got a lot of stuff I got to do this Saturday. We got to do a lot of packing because we are going, my son and I are going to summer camp on Sunday. And so Saturday, I kind of need that day to get all the stuff in order for summer camp, and I didn't want to deal with the regular errands of grocery shopping and running laundry for the week, so I took care of that today, which means I didn't draw at all. Have not drawn at all today. This is the first drawing of the day. Sometimes that's okay. Sometimes it's not good. Hawkeye Lego Man says, funny how there's that person that's gone for a brick convention that has their suggestion happening the same time. Like mine would have been during brick. Yeah, you know, it's weird. It's weird. It's not planned that way, I promise you. It's not like I've got this secret agenda where I'm like, how do I make it so that the people that make suggestions are not around? It is purely coincidental, I promise. But yeah, this is the second time that that's happened. Jeff says, driving brother-in-law to new home with Don. Don is there? What's up, Don? Can Don hear me? I need to know. It's imperative if Don can hear me. I already feel like I'm doing all kinds of weird stuff on this drawing already. But it's also kind of like a very oddly detailed face, too. Yep, there went a stable connection later. No problem. See you later, Jeff. Thanks for popping in for a little bit. I appreciate it. I hope you have a good drive. Say hello to Don for me. Catch you guys later. Oh, we gotta do like
Oh my goodness, the grotesque eye. Right, all this, all the details, just like, That's the whole point, though. That's the whole point of this.
Ray, have you been enjoying my insanely late art posting on Discord servers at like ungodly hours? It's not very fun. Having insomnia and stuff's not very fun. Oh yeah, and I guess probably, Bubble of O, you probably see it too. You are also probably privy to the extremely late, ridiculous art postings. I hope both of you have been enjoying. Why are you haunting Discord late at night? You haven't saw me? I mean, I pretty much do. I've got so much on my mind. I have so much on my mind. The Kickstarter's running, which I know that on its own, right? Ray, you know, you've done this. Having a Kickstarter project by itself is a huge thing to just be plaguing your mind. So I've got that, but I'm also like planning summer camp. I'm also in the middle of peak season for shows. I'm hopping from show to show to show to show. You know, and working on inventory. New month for Patreon, so I'm sending out all the Patreon envelopes. Which I need to do. I need to do a post about that. Because I realize my timing has shifted a little bit in the last 2 months. And there's a specific reason. And I haven't shared that. So I need to do that. So there's just a lot on my mind. You seem to do your best work 1 to 2:30 a.m. Suggest you change your life to keep doing. Yes. Seems like what I should do, right? Seems like a good idea. Seems like a solid suggestion. But yeah, it's just like there's too much and my mind can't rest. Which is not normally a problem for me, but right now it is a major problem for me. So all week long, I have been going to bed at like 2, 3. And I mean, I do stuff. I work, I draw, I sketch, because I can't do anything else. I don't know what to do. It's not good. It's not a fun time. It's really not a fun time. But there's been some cool stuff. Some cool things have been created. But at what cost? But at what cost were these things created? But yeah, I need to do a post up on Patreon because... So, those of you guys that are patrons, so Ray, Bobolevo, Hawkeye Lego Man, you guys know that I've usually been, up to now, I get your stickers in the mail really quick. Like, really quick. I'm like, oh, it's the first? Actually, last month? Or no, the month before last. I didn't even wait until the new month. I was, like, already on it, like, the 30th, 29th, 30th. So that's what I've done up until last month, and I realized something, which, I mean, I guess this is a duh moment, but it takes about a week. What's up, Eyebrow Express? I hope you can sleep your normal hours soon. Probably not until the Kickstarter's done. Probably not, if I had to guess. Bobo Laveau says, I enjoy the pictures in my evening work. Nice. Yeah, see, I can also tell you guys are night owls, the people that see it. So, back to my story. It bit me in the butt because I was sending out the Patreon rewards really, really early, kind of forgetting that it takes like a week or so for Patreon to run through and process everybody's credit cards, and it bit me in the butt because there was 2 months in a row where I sent out stuff to people and then they ended up bailing or canceling
their Patreon subscriptions, so they ended up getting the sticker for basically for free. And I'm like, I can't be doing that. Kevin doesn't have endless money and can't just be given stuff for free. So I'm like, I gotta stop. So I've adjusted my timing. So now I wait until everything goes through and I get the email from Patreon saying, all of your patrons have been charged and your money is on your way to your bank account. And then I will get all the envelopes ready to go. So it may not be as speedy as it used to be, but now I'm not risking sending stuff for free.
Racist brother, I am not sweating the sticker. Like, honestly, I like getting them, but I do remember that one person who told you never to send them anything because they, yeah, no, there are some people that, like, have opted out of physical rewards, which is fine. That's your choice. Eyebrow Express says, I struggle to stay awake all day. Then the moment night hits, I'm full batteries. Sometimes I feel like I should do that too.
You don't have to do that, Ray. It's part of the rewards. You enjoy your rewards, man. I offer it for a reason. I want you guys to have it. All right, this hair on this character is gigantic, right? Like massive. I mean, her head is massive. So it's kind of, they go hand in hand. Head and hair. We need to do some of this, I think. Yeah. That's exactly how I drew it before. You didn't see me adjust it. That's just how I drew it.
Hawkeye Lego Man says, I have to wake up early for work at 5 a.m. I'd be a night owl if I didn't have to wake up early.
Yep. That's also part of the problem. Part of the problem is we're in summer right now, so I'm not in the normal routine of having to wake up super early to get my son ready for school. We're just kind of like a wake up when we wake up. So it doesn't, that also adds to the problem. So I don't suspect it's a long-term thing. But right now, in the short term, it's very annoying. It's very obnoxious.
But yeah, on the plus side, some really cool stuff has been... some pretty cool sketch work and things have been coming out of that time. The Night Owl hours. I've been posting a lot of it on Discord.
Not my own Discord server. Goodness gracious, no. I don't need to add that to my life. So I just do that to other people's Discord servers. So if you happen to be on the Authocracy Discord server, or Eyebrow Express, or Brian, or there's so many. It takes me more time to promote the stream on all the Discord servers than it does on social media, which I know I've said that before, but it's just like, that's, to me, wild. It's wild that that's what takes the time, is all the Discord servers.
You guys recognize this character now? Funny Fix says, anyway, you can enjoy the Schadenfreude Freud of your patron's guilt for getting a sticker after not paying for it. What is that word? Schadenfreude. If you were a petty person like me anyway, there's gotta be a bot. Oh, a bot to like promote the streams and stuff?
Well, I mean, there's a couple servers that I'm in where they automatically share my stuff, which is super, super awesome. So Brian's Discord server does an automatic post in the Creator Club, which I'm very thankful for. I just found out, actually, today. I found out today that in another Discord server I'm in from Pandy, who pops in the stream every now and then, not Polish Panda, that they set me up to get auto promoted, which I thought that was really awesome of them. I had not noticed that. I didn't know. I don't know if that's brand new, but I was in the middle of writing it and then it was like already posted.
Hawkeye Lego Man, I was like, what Discord? Yeah, no, what Discord indeed. I don't need that in my life.
Don't worry, I don't have a Discord server. I just post to everybody else's.
I think I'm gonna do the rest of the body because, like, why not? Her body is really kind of simple. It's just like, it's also really tiny. But it's, it seems simple enough. Right? Maybe? Maybe? Maybe it's simple enough?
It's a gentleman's word for getting pleasure from someone else's misfortune or pain.
You would know that. Ray, that would be in your vocabulary. So, the problem with last night's work. So, I finished this Wario Land print, which has been popped over into some of the Discords. If you haven't seen it, you'll see it soon. But it's a new, like, mini art print. Really happy with it. I did it completely for myself. I didn't do it for anybody else but for me. I understand there is zero demand for Wario Land, Super Mario Land 3, 1994 Game Boy game artwork. I'm fully aware. But I did it for me. I like it. I had a lot of fun with it. And it's finished.
But I was in like a big Wario mood. Ray's gotta be right back.
Actually gotta work for a minute. I was in a Wario mood. And so I drew Wario again late last night during one of my nonsensical can't go to sleep things. But I drew him kind of as like in his boss pose from Super Mario Land 2 on Game Boy, because he was the big boss of that game. And I love it. I'm really happy with it. And now I'm like, oh no, what have I done? I can't have two nonsensical Wario prints that nobody wants. So I don't know what to do with it. I might, I guess, just do nothing with it? I don't know. I honestly don't know. Maybe it is just a thing I drew, but I really like it. I think it looks really nice. Nick Land says, you say there's zero demand, but how many other people have Wario? I know, that's true, but... I mean, I can hope. I can hope and pray, but... We'll see. The small one is gonna be a thing, for sure. So... But like two, I think two is pushing my luck a little too much. But I really like it. I like both of them for like different reasons. So I don't know. I don't know, I don't know. Conflicted, conflicted. The second one that I did, I think could be like a cool t-shirt. Like, I think it would be a really cool t-shirt, but I don't dare. I started a Redbubble account. I don't know if I told you guys this already. I started a Redbubble account. My first design got a cease and desist on it. That was literally, I opened the account and submitted one item, and it was like, copyright. I was like, well, I guess I'm done here. A lot of people had suggested I give it a shot, and I was like, I don't think you guys realize I can't really go anywhere. I can't, my stuff is all other people's property. Like, I can't go anywhere. I can't do it. There she is. We did it. There is Yubaba from Spirited Away, so we just need to color it. We just need to color her. So definitely get your suggestions down in the suggestion box if you have not done so already. Because as soon as I'm done coloring this, we will pick another villain.
Hawkeye Legoman says, post it and see if anyone likes it and ask to buy it. No, that doesn't work, Hawkeye Legoman, unfortunately. Unfortunately, that does not. I have tried that several times over the years, and that is definitely a proven way not to get good intel on what to sell. Unfortunately, I'm sorry to say. Nick Lands, it would be pretty funny if you have two prints of the same character at your boot. And so I know, it would be hilarious. It's like, what is this guy doing? He found his niche and it's all Wario. Although I'm wearing a Wario shirt right now. I love Wario. I was obsessed with Wario as a kid.
obsessed. The moment Wario appeared in the Mario universe, I was like, who is this guy? I need to know more about him. I was fascinated with Wario. Fascinated. I remember doing Wario-themed artwork in art class in, like, elementary school. I remember doing this. I remember my teacher being like, who's this? I'm like, this is a video game character that will change everything. Change the universe.
Everybody. Oh, of course I'll buy it. Launches the print and sells maybe one. Nick Lands knows we are from the same universe.
We are from the same universe. We know.
Hi, Kevin.
Larry Legend. What's up, Larry? How you doing? We're drawing villains, Larry. I know for a fact you got some villains. You got some villains in mind. Put them in the suggestion box. We need some ideas for villains. And thanks for popping in. Always nice to see you.
Larry, did you ever make a... did you ever make a suggestion for a Doodlestream theme?
Surely you did, right? Surely you did. I'm just not remembering it. Oh, my phone's battery's dying. Well, that's convenient. It's all right. I got a charger here. I'll plug it in.
Happy Friday, friends, says Larry. Hawkeye Lego Man says, at least posting it on social media. Oh, yeah. Oh, I'll do that for sure. I'll do that for sure. But yeah, unfortunately, I mean, as convenient as that would be, you can't really trust what people say in terms of what they would buy for artwork. It's kind of like, I remember when I did the dog stickers, right? I did the wave of dog portrait stickers and I posted them on social media. People were like going off on them. They loved it. They wanted more of it. And everybody's like, you gotta make cats. And I was like, well, I mean, I was already planning to make cats. I wasn't gonna just do dogs, but everybody. I mean, I lost track of how many comments were like, if you do cats, I'll buy all of them. People say these outlandish things, like, I'll buy everything you have. And it's like, oh, okay, let's put that to the test, shall we? And then, yeah, I did the cats, which was only like a month later, maybe less, maybe 3 weeks later. Those people did not come out and buy them. I was like, where did all you people go? What happened? Larry says, yeah, I forgot what it was, and you did it. Oh, well, good.
I don't remember what it was either. What did you want, Larry? What did Larry want me to draw? Does anyone remember what theme Larry Legend wanted? Surely you can't forget a name like Larry Legend.
Hawkeye says, I got my cat, I think.
Did you? I sent out at least one in the Patreon.
Here's another question for you patrons that are happen to be here right now. Do you guys care if you don't all get the same sticker every month? Does that mean anything to you? Because, oh, it was caricatures. You're right, Larry. On the money. It was caricatures, you're right. That was gonna drive me crazy. But yeah, I'm wondering if you guys care if you get this, if you all get the same sticker, because I'm wondering if I can just randomly pick out stickers for everybody instead of everybody getting the same sticker. Does anybody care? You guys care?
You probably don't care. I can't imagine you guys caring.
Orange tabby.
Nice. Larry doesn't have a preference. And see, I asked this for very selfish reasons. Because sometimes I don't have the stock that I want. And it's kind of inconvenient. So I have to, like, order more because I need to have, like, 60 of the same sticker. And a lot of times I don't. Like, I don't maintain that much inventory. So a lot of times I end up having to place another order. Which is fine, because then I would just keep the sticker and keep using it. It'd be in the assortment for shows and everything. But, like, I'm like, can I find a way to not do that? Like, not place an order specifically for patrons. No offense. Like, the point is to, like, pull from existing inventory for this.
Hawk of Lego Man also does not have a preference. Cool.
Okay, I think that's what I'm going to do. So I'm going to announce that too soon. I'm wondering if I have enough stock of, for this month, of something. I'll have to take a look. But yeah, we'll probably shift very soon to, like, it just, you'll still get a sticker every month. It just means you all won't get the same sticker. That's all I'm saying, is that, like, different people will get different stickers.
Larry says, I just give all mine to the homeless anyway. That's, you know, that's really nice of you, Larry. Man, what a good Samaritan you are. Could you spare some change? No. But here's this wonderfully designed decal of legendary Super Mario character Yoshi. You're welcome. Hawkeye Lego Man says, that moment when you're building a horror-based hallway system in Minecraft and a bat just spawns at the end of the hallway. Yep, it works. That sounds pretty cool. Is that what you, I assume that's what you're doing? Can I assume that is what you're doing? All right, we're just about done with this. So if you, as I've said already, but I'll say it again, if you have any suggestions for a theme, put them in the suggestion box. Because I'm about to go through there and pick one.
Larry's just by homeless. I mean my kids.
Oh. Oh.
I get what you mean. I'm aware of this. But yeah, Larry, like we were talking about the other day, I would love to make it out to like a Fan Expo Denver or something. One day. Right now I'm still kind of limited to, you know, decently drivable distances, no more than like, I don't know, 9 hours, 8 hours, 9 hours. Because I don't have my system streamlined for flight. And I don't know if I necessarily ever will. Maybe I will. And I don't really want to ship stuff, and my anxiety goes way up when I'm like no longer in control of my products and they're like out of my grasp. And then they're, I mean, what happens? Worst case scenario, right? It's like, okay, well, then I have nothing to sell. It's like, that's stressful. Super stressful. You know what I mean? I kicked them all out. Oh, nice. Good job, Larry. Eventually you got to. You know, you have to. What will they learn? You know? What will they learn? You gotta leave the nest sometime. I was out. The minute I turned 18, I was out. Like, I'm not even kidding. Same thing for, like, when I could drive. Like, the moment I could drive, I was driving. Which was, like, 15. in Austin, and I got my learner's permit, and I wasn't supposed to drive by myself, and I just did it all the time anyway. But I was like, oh, I can drive? I'm gone. Goodbye.
Hawkeye Legoman says, the largest Michigan con is supposed to be this weekend, not going. Larry, JK, my three kids, 22, 19, 17, are waiting on their new place to be ready. Two of them are here. They pick out some sticky art. Nice. The minute the Navy wanted me at 18, I had no choice.
Well, yep, that's also one way to do it.
Okay. I think that's it. I think we're done with her, right? There she is. Do you recognize her? Do you recognize her from the timeless film? This is a great film, by the way. If you haven't seen Spirited Away, it's a fantastic, fantastic film. You go anywhere else. How about right there? All right, I'm going to dive into the suggestion box. Moment of truth. What do we got in here? We got 9 suggestions. Sweet. Oh, Larry's on it with Vecna from Stra. I should probably do that, right? The internet demands I should do that, shouldn't I? Let's do that one next. The internet demands it. Let me plug in my phone, too. So we're gonna do Vecna from Stranger Things next, which is actually Larry's suggestion. I'm looking through some reference images. I think I just want to do like his face. I think, especially because I just did like a full. I just did a full body. Right? They can't all be. Let's calm down. Can all be that way. Yeah, totally. You know Hawkeye Lego Man, you know. Okay. One equals Vecna, right? Yes. One is Vecna. And, oh, what's his name? He has a real name. They say his name in the show. I can't remember what it is, though. Does anybody remember what they say his name is? His last name's Creel. Because his dad is Victor Creel. Is it... Why do I want to say Josh? Joshua? Is that right? Ross? Was it Ross? I can't remember what his name is. Doing this like head tilt thing going on here. See, again, now that's gonna drive me crazy. I'm trying to think about what it is. Does he still have ears? I mean, not really. Doesn't really have ears. I think I'm gonna do one eye and copy and paste it because we don't need to be heroes here. Larry says, can you believe Stranger Things started in 2016? I can't. I cannot believe that, actually. I feel like, what is time? Right? Like, what even is time, though? Let's see how much of this I can get away with. Let's see. Remember, when I do this, it usually looks kind of goofy at first. Okay? Don't be a Ray and make fun of me. Ray always makes fun of me every time I do this.
Because it does look goofy at first. But you see, look how goofy that looks. You gotta wait. You have to give me like 5 seconds. Ray's ruthless. He doesn't wait at all. He's like, look how dumb that looks. Like, stop it. Stop it. I think, so if you guys were here on Tuesday, I was sharing that I had done a sticker order recently, and I got some more Doodle stickers, which are always a hit out in the conventions. And I was kind of having trouble picking out one. I had already put 4, and I wanted to do 5, and I was like, I need one more. And I couldn't for the life of me figure out a good one to go with. So I just kind of settled. And I added in Kermit and Miss Piggy, which actually means I have 2 Kermits, because I have Kermit sipping the tea and then Kermit Miss Piggy. And then like almost minutes of placing the order, I'm like, I should have done Stranger Things. Because I've been asked a lot for Stranger Things stuff. And I do have a Demogorgon drawn from a while ago. Granted, it's from a 2019 episode, but it still looks pretty good. It was one of the good ones from the year. So it was like on the poster, like it had a primary real estate on the poster. You guys remember the posters? Larry says 001 was in the show Camelot. Ah. Hawkeye Lego Man, it's like that trend of the mirror flip challenge with both halves of your face. Yes, it is. I gotta add some deep shadows here on this side. We gotta push it further over here. The IMDb only lists him as Orderly / Vecna. I am so certain they said his name. But yeah, like I said, we positively know his last name because we met his dad.
Hi, Kevin.
What's up, Pandy? I was just talking about you. Don't worry. All good stuff. Don't you worry about it. All good things. All good things, I promise. I was saying that I just noticed on the Discord server that I'm now like auto listed when I live stream, which I thought was really, really nice of you guys. So thank you. I know that's like a joint Discord server that you have. So it's not just you, but I do appreciate that. That was awesome to see. I was in the middle of like putting my post up and I was like, oh, I'm automatically, oh. That was super cool. Very nice of you guys to do that for me. I am honored. I'm in the cool kids club. Larry says he also played young Grindelwald. Oh. This is definitely his, this is his breakout role though. This one for sure. For sure. There's no way it isn't. There's no way it's not. Hawkeye Lego Man says, did you hear that Seven survived from Stranger Things? He grew up and became an undercover agent. What? No, I did not hear. I did not hear this. I did not hear this.
Oh.
That went over my head on that one. That one went over my head on that one. My apologies. My apologies. That one went over my head. But yeah, what's going on, Pandy? How are you doing?
We're doing villains. Today's theme is villains.
We're drawing villains today. So as always, if you have a suggestion, please feel free to add it to the suggestion box.
I think that's all I want to do for this one, I believe. So let me add some colors. Larry says, wow. And that was low. I just didn't put it together. Pandy says, I'm good. How are you? Doing okay. Doing okay. Bubble Lowe says, this may be your most realistic face. Are you being serious? Don't lie to me. I feel like you're lying to me. It kind of looks like Tony Stark. All right. Okay, see? See, there we go. No, I have a response for that now. Hold on. There you go. Villains are cool. They can be, you know? They absolutely can be. So, I need, like, just a lot of reds, huh? Basically. Sorry, Kevin, that's what I do with low-hanging fruit. It's all right, Larry. If it keeps you around, you do whatever your heart desires, Larry. Larry, you just do whatever you want to do.
Hi, Kevin.
Hi, Ray. Are you back, Ray? Are you back with us?
Have you returned?
Looks like Tony Stark. Get out of here. With this.
You know what's funny, Larry? There's been so many times that I have gone back through the artwork and I'm like, to pick things maybe to redraw or whatever. And I always look back at that Tony Stark and I'm like, this is not a bad drawing. I keep looking at it and I'm like, oh, maybe they're right. Maybe I need to do it. And I look at it, I'm like, this is not a bad drawing. This is not a bad drawing. You know, because as I've told you guys a lot of times, I don't mind redrawing stuff if I think I can do better. And I totally agree that maybe the likeness isn't like spot on, but it's not a bad drawing. It's certainly not to the point where I feel like I need to redraw it. I'm like, no, this is fine. But there's been a lot of times where I've like thought, oh, should I redo that? I'm like, no, I shouldn't redo this. No, it's fine. It looks perfectly fine. I'm just doing random things now. Just randomly putting random colors. Said with love. Funny Fix is, yes, sorry we messed up an escrow in like 2017. Oh, really? Somebody was calling to complain about like, hello, I have a complaint about something that happened several years ago. Is this the right number? Put it up to the mirror. So when do new patron themes? Is Tony Stark indifferent? Oh my goodness. A whole theme based on that? Oh, goodness gracious. Goodness gracious. But, yeah, to your earlier comment,
Bubble of O. There is an upcoming stream that's themed back on Fill the Scene again, but that was like, I need to look at my list. That wasn't like right off the bat. I think it was like a couple weeks away. So it's gonna happen, but it's not right away. I feel like I'm probably done with this. Funny Vix, no, it's my job to find the problems. I inspect the FAA records. Oh. Larry Legend says, I'm down with that. But I did have a customer tell me I was wrong today and had to pull out like 10 documents to prove I was right. Well, that means you're in the service industry, Ray. For sure. If you're being told you're wrong, you are absolutely in the service industry, my friend. Which you know you are. Okay, I think I just want to do... Let's do one last thing, and then we'll be done with this one. We got to do... a little glint. Just some... There we go. I thought you said this... That this was Fill the Scene with Joseph. Oh. Maybe I said it. Maybe I misspoke. But the Fill the Scene is Steve... Steve's second suggestion is Fill the Scene, which Steve was the first one that suggested it. So Steve is going for Steve is pulling a Matt Elder, as it were, where Matt Elder's first suggested theme was horses and his second suggested theme is horses. So Steve is like, my first one is Fill the Scene, my second one is Fill the Scene. I'm like, oh, okay. All right, there's our Vecna. So we have Yubaba and Vecna. So now we did a super realistic one, so let's go a little bit more cartoony again. I think I saw at least one or two. All right, I'm gonna mark that as complete in the suggestion box. Again, if anyone just popped in, remember, I do take suggestions from the chat. We're doing villains, so it just has to be somehow relating to villains, but you can write that into the chat. Yeah, I think we need to do Dr. Doofenshmirtz. Let's do that one next. That's a definitely difference from this one. All right, let me get my reference. Oh, that's it. That's the face I want right there. That's the pose. Larry says, I'm really digging this one, Kevin. You could easily crank out some zombie art. Oh, yeah. Thank you, Larry. I just got to make them all look all crazy and decrepit and stuff. Falling apart. Funny Fixes, it's true, but I'm not used to having this kind of customers who buy $1 million planes. That's very fair. Very fair. So we're doing Dr. Doofenshmirtz. This is the Eyebrow Express's suggestion from Phineas and Ferb. Watch it come together before your very eyes. Everyone loves the Fill in the Scene. Yes, Hawkeye Lego Man knows all too well. It is definitely a fun like departure from the norm. But not all the time. Just a fun departure. I get stressed because it breaks all my conventions. So I'm like, how do I? I gotta like reevaluate how I do all my things. Which is okay. That's why it's fun to do every now and then. I don't think I've ever drawn this character.
Unless I'm totally wrong. Don't think I have. Doofin Smurts. Oh, thank you. Doofin Schmurts. Evil Incorporated. I need to switch the these eyes. I think need to be tilted a little bit. Let me do another layer for the head. Yes. You have to sing it. It's been so long, I wouldn't even know the proper jingle, man, to be honest. I remember there was like a little jingle, but I can't, in my head, I can't imagine what it is right now. Like, it's been way too long. Of course, if I heard it, I'd be like, oh yeah, there it is. But like, I can't imagine it right now. Which potentially makes you say, no, that's right, okay. I was like, wait a minute, I thought I was on a different layer. Layer check. Layer check, folks. That's why there's a layer check emote now. Boo, sorry. Both of those is the last one sounded right. Agree, singing is important. Literally just sing talk. Doofenshmirtz Evil Incorporated. Okay, we got right here.
Wow.
Yes.
You did these?
Yes, I did.
Yep.
I'm really proud of you. Thanks, Ray. Although I feel like you're just doing that because I did that half-hearted sing, and not because I drew something. Is this true?
Jack, I want you to draw me like one of your French girls.
You got it. You got it, Ray. Okay. Do you guys ever do you guys know Butch Hartman? It's the guy that did like Fairly Odd Parents, Danny Phantom. I know he's done other stuff.
Oh Jesus! Oh God! Oh Jesus, God, Mary, Mother of Jesus, Jesus of Nazareth!
Yes. I follow him on social media. He does some, like, he does some cool stuff. Like, people will post on his social stuff being like, hey, can you draw so-and-so in your style? And he does it all the time. Oh, no, I know that too, Ray. I'm also aware of that. But, like, I still like his stuff. But, yeah, there was something he... What was it? That, like, that one... Right? He did, like, an actual commission. And, like, he used... Like, he didn't use... Well, the reference he used was somebody else's fan art of the character. Which, I mean, I've been there. I've done that dozens of times. When I'm, like, opening up Google, I'm like, yeah, what is my... What is my reference? But I think, as far as I know, unless there's more to this story that I don't know, but he did a commission. It was like an anime character, I believe, and he opened up Google to get a reference, and he got reference, but the reference was somebody else's fan art of the character, not like official. And then they were all mad because they're like, you took my artwork or whatever. And I mean, the guy is like very successful. Obviously, he's made cartoons and such, so there was some anger. Okay, I think I'm gonna make this skinnier.
But, like, I think genuinely he seems like a really nice guy. I mean, again, you never know, but
I don't have any animosity towards him. I know his work, but have not had the tea. Ah, yes, use the Kermit. Here's our Kermit. Spill the tea. So you get all the Kermits on the screen. But, like I said, unless there's more to this that I don't know, that is all that I know of. But I do enjoy seeing him tackle people's requests. Kind of like this. But so he'll, like, yeah, people will post, hey, can you draw, you know. I think he got asked recently to draw, like, Eddie from Stranger Things in his, like, style. And he does it, and it's fun. I'm gonna have to draw these hands, right? Yeah, I'm gonna have to draw these stupid hands. Ugh. Hands! Can we get the hands emote, please? Can we get a rainstorm of hands? Thank you. Thank you, Ray. Ugh. It's so funny. I was showing those. Yes, thank you.
No matter how anybody says it is, feels good to have made something.
This is true. It does. It does feel good to have made something. Thank you, Bubble of O, for the hands. Exclamation point hands. Yeah, it is. 131 times, man. Embarrassing. How embarrassing. How embarrassing for me. Is it just those three? Yeah, he has four fingers. Okay, alright. Alright, that's fine. Bubble of a. Whose is this? Whose is this? Angel W32. Twerkin. Oh, I didn't even see Ray snuck in a horse/weremare at the end of that. I didn't even notice that. I think you're slick. I think I need to do, again, another layer. I don't know if I want to actually draw all of him. I don't think I want to. I don't think it's necessary, I should say. I'm kind of selective in which characters I do, like, all of the character versus, like, a bust or half body. I'm like, is it worth it? Would it help? Would it help, like, further sell who this is, you know? Like, do you need it? Do you need it is my question. My question is, do you need it? Okay, so we get rid of the. I've got too many layers now. I don't even know what layer I'm on. The true definition of a layer check. Okay, that's all together now. All right, and then we'll do another layer for this other hand. This other evil hand. Yeah, I already hate this. It's okay, we can do this. We can do this. It's all right. It's all right. Take your time. We can do this. You know what? It's not just good. It's good enough. Thank you, Bobo Lavo. That's why it's there. The layer check is there for this purpose.
The layer check is here for that purpose. I appreciate you. I appreciate you. Okay. Thank you, Larry. It's my favorite piece of art. I will always be more of a Zelda fan than Mario, but it's, I mean, I really do like Mario. I really am a big Mario fan, but man, Zelda just squeezes it out on the top. I feel like his chin should be thinner.
Of course, that's a different line weight now, because it is.
Of course. No, I think instead of trying to make all these other lines...
We don't make mistakes. We have happy accidents.
I know,
Larry. I know. Thank you for the reminder.
There, it's fine. It's fine. This is fine. Good job, Sonny. Today's musical selection feels particularly good. Thank you, Bolivo. It's the same playlist, which I like this play. It's like a synth kind of playlist, which I really enjoy, but every now and then, they get some weird ones in there. It's just like, it's good most of the time. And then there's a weird, like, every now and then we'll get into, like, this weird vocal. We get to some of these vocal ones, and they're just really odd. And I'm like, I'm out. And then I gotta, like, mess with it. It's kind of like me and my schedule. It's like, I'm here every Friday, except when I'm not. The playlist works exceptionally well most of the time, until it doesn't. Until it doesn't work. Thank you guys for being here. Super awesome to have you guys hanging out with me on this Friday. Especially because I'm gonna have to miss the stream next Friday again because I will be at a show. So next Friday is Fan Expo Boston, which I will be at, and it does have a Friday, so there is a Friday on the books, so that means I can't stream and be at the show at the same time. Unfortunately, I have not perfected the art of cloning, I wish I had.
Larry says, it's been a minute, Kevin. I miss this. You know, I'm glad you're here, Larry.
I can tell when people aren't here. Especially folks that are here, you know, regularly. When you're not here, I can tell. I try not to let it bother me. I know people have lives. But I can tell. I'm like, oh, haven't seen so-and-so in a while. Haven't seen, you know, whoever it is for the day.
Bobo Laveau, so for the Kickstarter, the random hand horse robot drawing, do you have a bunch of those prepared? No, I haven't done any of them yet. Or will you, like, a period of time? Yeah, there'll be a period of time where I work on all the backer rewards. Because there's also the commissions, which there's only 10 of those, but those will probably take me about an hour or so each, maybe a couple hours each, because that's what I do for the shows. I do those at events, and it usually takes me about an hour. But then, yeah, I will go through and do those at the same time, probably. Those will be a lot less because those are single color, like exactly as you see it in the like explainer image. It's like it's a single color little sketch on a sketch card. Larry says, is Fan Expo the biggest one of the biggest you do? No. Well, I would say it was until I went to DC. Because I went to DC for AwesomeCon, which was gigantic. And I would certainly say Fan Expo Boston would fit inside of AwesomeCon. And Fan Expo Boston's pretty big. That was also the first show. AwesomeCon was the first show I've done where it was not a guaranteed in if you applied. So there was a jury selection, and they had to like look through your stuff and review your work, and like just because you applied didn't mean anything. That one's definitely the biggest I've done. I've only done it once. I mean, I hope to do it again. I will apply again, but it's not a guarantee. Even if you've already done it, it's not a guarantee you'll go back. So that one is definitely the biggest, and I think it's in there like top 10 of the country. Pretty sure. It's up there. Hawkeye Lego Man says, you should consider to broadcast the convention. I should not consider that. Larry Legends says, heck, I was there for Build Tuesdays or whatever day. Yep. That was the, what is it? Backlog building. Memories, man. Larry's trying to take us down memory lane today. See, now, Larry, I don't know if you know this, Larry. I just added, it's still relatively new, and it doesn't have nearly the same, like, attendance that, this does, but I stream on Tuesdays now. I have a studio hours live stream, so I just work on whatever. So I work on prints, I work on stickers, I work on commissions, or I work on nothing. Like, last Tuesday I just did, like, a event recap. We talked about Terrificon, which was the show I had just done. I showed off pictures of my booth, and I showed all the commissions I did while at the show. That was pretty good. I enjoyed that a lot. I do that in the afternoon. So that's Tuesdays at like 12:30-ish. I try to be as on time as I can, but like 12:30-ish. Until I only do that one for 2 hours. Larry says, Fan Expo Denver was insane. I blame you so much, Kevin. Oh, well, that's fine. Ho ho, Barry Barry's here. What's up, Tim? Broadcasting the con would be so hectic trying to interact with two completely different. Oh my goodness, yes. Oh my goodness, yes. It would be wild.
It's probably the best drawing I've ever done.
Hey, thanks. It probably is. Who said that? Larry said that. Thank you, Larry. Whoops. Layer check. Can I get a layer check, please? No. We gotta fuse them together. We gotta fuse them together, silly. Silly? What are you doing? I'm gonna fuse them together. Look at the difference between these guys. Thank you, Bubble of Up. Look at the difference. The difference of them. All right, I'm gonna go into the suggestion box and pick another villain. So if you're just joining, don't forget there is a suggestion box. You can add your suggestion for a villain, and I might draw it. Okay, let's look through what we got. What do we got? Bobolovo, you and your gummies. I think that you're up. I think that's your second, right? Your second stream suggestion is like all gummy bears. I'm like, oh lord, a whole stream of gummy bears. Let me look up. I don't know some of these. I need to look up what they are. As per usual, I don't know some of these. As per usual. Okay, yeah, all right. So we've got, so Nick Lance has suggested a character appears from Naruto, which is definitely popular. So I think we should probably do this. Orochimaru? I think that's how you say it. I don't know if that's how you say it. But we'll do that one next. Speaking of odd music, this one started off a little weird, but it's okay, right? Well, maybe I spoke too soon. There's some weird sound effects. Did the song just start having a blood-curdling scream? Perhaps. I expect you to set a... Oh, there's the scream. I expect you to set a record for most doodles on the guy. Yeah, I might. What is this? Okay, hold on. I'll change the music. Like I said, it works pretty good most of the time. And then every now and then there's a weird track. And it's like, let's change that one. Most of the time, it works fine. Ochimaru. Oh, thank you. Appreciate that. I always appreciate the assist in pronunciation. Alright. Because I don't know. I try to know. I can't know everything. Alright, so... Yeah, Naruto is obviously very popular. I've never watched it, but I have one sticker, and it sells pretty well. I've reordered it. That's how you know it sells well, is if you've reordered it. There are plenty of things I ordered once, and I have never reordered again. Plenty of them.
It's probably the best drawing I've ever done.
It probably is. I haven't even done anything yet. I'm already accepting the compliment, and I'm like, oh, thank you. Oh, wait a minute. You know it's from Naruto because we got the headband. That's how you know. That's how you know. I'm not, like, super happy with that hair. I don't think the outline, at least. I'll come back to that in a second, okay? Can you wait a second? Can you just hold on a second? Hawkeye Lego Man says, sounds like a toddler when they stub their foot. The music? Tim says, he is an evil sneck boy. Oh, yeah? He kind of looks sneckish. Speaking of anime... I'm further into the Demon Slayer show. Nice! Are you further along than me? What's up, Jinxie425? Hello! Hi! How's the new computer? The new computer is awesome. The new computer is working swimmingly. Thank you for your contributions for said new computer device. I greatly appreciate it. I sent you a message. I don't know if you saw it. You never replied to it. But if you didn't know, there's a message waiting for you. In the Patreon messaging system. There we go. That was definitely frozen on the image. I didn't move. I wasn't moving for a second. It could have been that. Funny fixes have to say the side characters are possibly the worst characters I've ever seen. Are you talking about Demon Slayer? Bolo says I see no hair. Yeah, I deleted it. I got rid of it. Ouchie Mafu. The Eyebrow Express says, good on Naruto for taking the uniform approach and having a design element that is both unique and carries into almost every design into the series, so it's immediately recognizable. Yes. Agreed. I would agree with that. I think we can also guarantee that I'm going to copy and paste this eye, too. If we just come to terms with this now, it will be less shocking that Kevin will copy and paste this eye. Okay? Okay? Okay.
Oh, this is still all the same layer, isn't it? Interesting. I thought by now I would have made a new one.
Yeah, yellow guy and pig head.
Those guys are great, Ray. You shut your mouth. Those guys are awesome. How dare you say they're awful? Raymond. See, this is why. This is why, Ray. This is... How dare you say those guys are awful? You hate them. Raymond. Raymond, if I remembered your middle name, I would have used it right now in a heartbeat. In a heartbeat. In a heartbeat. How can you hate them? They are amazing. I can't believe you. I cannot believe you, Ray.
Oops.
One's defining character trait is he is always loudly. Yeah, that's what makes him hilarious. He's always scared. It's great. I don't know what to do with you, Ray. Jinxie425 says, funny thing, 2 days after my donation, my computer died. Oh, that's terribly unfortunate. Just got my new one running this. Well, that is awful. I'm glad you have a new one. I'll check my Patreon message. Nice, 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 nice. Yes, let me know. Let me know. Let me know. Now, before I do that, before I do this, action. I think I want to do the mouth first. And the other one is a cheap Vegeta Naka. Okay, Ray. Alright, Ray, we need to calm down for a second. Right? I think we're saying some things we don't mean. I think we're a little caught up in the moment right now. I think everybody just needs to calm down. When you're calm, Ray, we can talk about it. When you've calmed down, we can discuss it. Like gentlemen. No, I think it needs to be said. No, nope. And I'm not afraid to say it. Ray is just ecstatic right now. He is just out of his mind. He is out of his mind right now, everybody. Everybody be careful. Ray is out of his mind. I'm sorry. Bubble Vos says, art fight. Two
hey,
artists enter.
Listen.
And I'm listening. And two artists leave it in an art fight, not the Coliseum people. Oh, yeah. No, I totally want to do... I do want to do some, like, art fights, though. I do. I really do want to. I've been thinking about it. I've been plotting. All right. Now that I'm done with this face, I think I can zoom out a second. Like, super close.
Oh, Jesus! Oh, God!
Yes!
Oh,
yes!
Oh, Jesus! God! Oh!
Yes!
Mary, yes. Mother, Jesus, Jesus, of Nazareth!
Yes!
We don't go around altering valuable art, okay?
The joyfulness is over, alright, Ray?
I think I've improved on your methods a bit, too. I employed
some chiaroscuro shading.
I'll improve on your methods!
What?
You're making us a little bit uncomfortable.
Ray's using all the exposure buck he's saved.
Oh, yeah. Art.
Ray's like, I no longer need these. That's the spirit, Ray. I'm sorry that Ghostbusters 2 clip is a little quiet. I can't change it. It's a little quiet. It's quieter than the other ones, but like all of them are connected. So like I can't change the volume of that one and not change the volume of all the alerts. So unfortunately, that just is how it is. To my dismay, because I would like it to be a little bit louder. But I guess I can't. But if you couldn't hear him, I have limited powers, but by God, I will use them. He says, no, Dr. Venkman, we will not alter valuable art. Please go. The joyfulness is over. Which I laugh. It's so funny. I love that movie. I love Ghostbusters 2, all right? I don't know why people don't like Ghostbusters 2. I love Ghostbusters 2. I would say, and I've said it before, and some people don't like it, that I like Ghostbusters 2 more than I like Ghostbusters 1. Sorry. I hate to break it to you. I hate to be the bearer of bad news. Now, that doesn't mean I don't like Ghostbusters 1. I do, but Ghostbusters 2 is excellent. See, you know what I could be doing? I could be using the mirror tool, but why would I think ahead? It's probably best that I don't, because for this, everything is so different on this show that it probably wouldn't make sense to be using, because I'd have to like just leave it on, and I don't think I want to do that. I don't think I want to do that, actually. On second thought, no, that's a bad idea. Larry Legend says, how did you like Afterlife? I liked it. I mean, I didn't think it was, like, incredible. I know that there was, like, a lot of chatter about people being like, oh my goodness, this was, like, literally the best thing ever. And I'm like, the best thing ever. I'm like, yeah, it was all right. It was a good movie. I certainly was not dissatisfied with it. So, it was all right. You know what? I loved the kids. I thought the kids were awesome. And Egon's, like, granddaughter, right? I thought she was, like, an amazing actor. And I loved her character. And I'm like, yeah, I want to see this team. And I liked, wasn't it, a podcast? I thought it was fun. But it did not change my life. Okay, I think I'm at that point where I have to fix the hair. Oh, I can do the headband now. Funny Fix says, we just tried to watch it last night. The heads scared my kids, so we had to stop. But I was laughing the whole time. Ghostbusters 2, that is. The heads scared my kids. The heads on the, you mean in the subway? The heads on the, like, pikes? Yeah, McKenna, what's her name, is great. Yeah, she was, like, really awesome. She knocked it out of the park. Just, like, her persona and stuff, it was, like, great. I had such a hard time, though, trying to, like, buy the whole storyline of, like, these lifelong friends, right? Egon and Stan, and Ray. These lifelong friends. And he's like, nah, I'm not gonna talk to you ever again. I'm like, really? And then also just like Ray not believing Egon. It just seems like kind of not believable. Like, really though? But I don't know. It wasn't enough for me to dislike it. I was just like, really?
But yeah, I feel like a lot of times in the Ghostbusters stuff, it's like always about Zool. It's all Zool all the time. And I guess like, okay, I guess Zool is like your big bad. I get it. All right. But like, it can be someone different every time. We had Viggo the Carpathian. I love Viggo. Viggo is awesome. You are like flies to him. Larry says, we did a huge plastic brick collab of that movie. Did you? What scene did you do? All right, I need another layer for this hair before I mess it up. It's really just like round, but I feel like if I do a stupid shape, it's like game over. You know what I mean? You guys know what I mean, though? I mean, I guess that's it, really. Most of the movie. BTV has a review. I see. That's cool. I'm assuming then that you guys really liked it. I'm assuming you quite enjoyed.
That's dandy. Ho, that's rich.
That's rich, I'll say.
Now how about some color, stupid?
I know. It's about that time. Yeah, let's color it. All right. Let's color it and move on. Ken did an amazing field of traps with lights. That's cool. I'm sure with the lights it was really nice. It was like a really cool effect. So is anybody doing anything interesting this weekend? Everybody just chilling. Like I said, I gotta get ready for scout camp. So we gotta run through the packing list, make sure we got all the things that we need. Which is always more than I think. I'm always like, what do we need? And I'll put together a thing, and then I look at the list, and I'm like, oh, I need a lot more things. I need many more things than this. Them Duke boys are building blocks again. Yes, Ray. Bowl of us is Brick Fair, Virginia tomorrow. Oh, nice, are you going? I assume if you're going just tomorrow, then you're just going public time, huh? Just to see the sights and walk around. You didn't sign up for the full immersion experience? Larry says, yeah, he has the catching ghost mode transition to caught ghost. Nice. We officially list our old house for sale Monday, says Ray. Well, congratulations and good luck. Bolo says, I am going public time. Yep. I hope you have a good time. I hope you see our boy
internet superstar Kirk Wilson. I heard Brian's there. Hopefully I said that deadpan enough. I am never getting time off from work long enough to go to the hotel. Got it. Yep, that'll do it. If you can't get out of work, then that kind of settles that. Settles those plans. Ready to hang with Kurt. Nice. Nice. Very nice. All right, we got to do like... This guy is very pale. Very pale. You know what's unfortunate, Tim, is the... For the emote wall, which is the name of the... It's the name of the application that pushes those emotes in front of the screen and they kind of like dance around. It takes for the animated emotes the first frame because it won't animate them as they're bouncing around, which is already a shame. But so that one where I'm popping up and I have the pin, the first frame is orange because I haven't, it's like that very first frame is me coming up. And so like the, it's just the orange squares. Behold the orange squares. Larry says, I got to meet Kirk and Brian in the RL in Chi-Town. In the RL. What does that mean? What does RL mean? I wonder if we did enough of those emotes, it would block out the screen. You can try. Go ahead. Try to block the whole screen out. It gets kind of hard, actually, to, like, spam emotes.
With this tool, I shall give birth to art!
Yes. Thank you. Thank you, Hawkeye Lego Man. Real life. Oh, okay, that's what RL means. Real life, you say. You guys are doing okay. How do you feel you're doing? No, I don't like that color. It definitely is like a gray, actually. Like the shadow, at least on this screenshot, it's like really just gray. It kind of feels weird to just do gray, but I don't know. What do I know, I guess?
Well, art is not all fun and games.
That's right.
It's a lot of hard work.
It is. It is. Tim says, I call that close enough. Good. That's what I like to hear. It's close enough. Look at this engage. I know. Look at you guys being engaging. I'm proud of you guys. I'm proud of you. Your engagement will be great on this one. Ochimaru has gray/purple skin. Wow. Purple skin. Because he's like a snake. Is he made out of snake? Is he half snake? I've never watched Naruto. I've never seen any of Naruto. I will eventually. It's on the list. Everything's on the list. His eyes definitely look more purplish, like a very kind of palish purple. Kind of. I'll just go with it. Somebody once looked at my Naruto sticker, they were like, that's the wrong eye color. And I was like, literally no one has ever said that to me. It's like, no one has ever said that. Not that I, like, don't believe him. I'm just like, that's never been said before. I think I gotta follow this reference image. Because we got some blood action going on here. I feel like that sells it. Right? He summons purple snakes. So if you tint purple a bit, it... Oh, interesting. I watched the first few seasons when I was younger. Funny figs, they go around trying to capture different types of ninjas to become the very best that anyone ever was. Oh, of course. So then go to the Ninja League. The eye highlights face paint is purple. Oh. That's face paint. I thought it was like shadows. That makes a lot more sense. Right? This part is what you're talking about. I thought that was like shadows. Look at you guys helping me. Look at you being influential. Thank you for that. Thank you. Appreciate it. Appreciate it. See, this is why I get worried sometimes when I draw stuff that I'm not familiar with. Because I'm like, I'm going to mess up and do something really obviously dumb that people that know the source are like, why would you do that? That's what I feel like. I mean, a lot of times that doesn't happen, but I feel like that's going to happen. Is someone's going to be like, they're going to call me out on something. I'm like, I don't know what you're talking about. What do you mean it's not right? I looked at the reference. I followed Google. That really backfired on me. I want you to create a good sticker for the authentic weebs. Appreciate it. Appreciate it. Isn't messing up a beloved franchise the best part? Oh, it is. So yeah, what really... I think I talked about this, right? Didn't I talk about this on Tuesday? But I did this character Biken from Guilty Gear. That was a commission I got. I'm not familiar with the character. So I looked it up and she's like a samurai, I don't know, ninja warrior. But I could not tell from the reference that she had one arm. Because she had this long sleeve, and the sleeve was always like trailing behind her as she's like in all these action poses and running. And so I just thought her hand was obscured by the sleeve. And I drew her with two hands, two arms, and the internet was sure to let me know that was incorrect. I was like, well, the guy that bought it from me didn't say anything. Okay, that one is done? No, wait, we need to do the zipper. The zipper. And the buttons. There we go. Now it's done. What's up, Arctic Arts? How you doing, man? We're drawing villains. Today's villain day. Are you a villain? Is Arctic Arts a villain? I think you might be. I think you might be a villain. What is it? See, most of the... Yeah, now I'm just going to add extra arms to everything. I don't... See, sometimes... Let me move here. There we go. It's good until it's not good. Arctic Arts says, I'm having a very rough day, but I'm doing some studies and it's helping. Good. You know what's funny, Tim? I just drew Bill Cipher on our triangle episode. Oh my goodness. When was that? Like five-ish weeks ago? We did a whole episode on triangles, and that was one of the prompts. That was pretty funny. All right. Let's see. Let's go back to the suggestion box. I trust we've got some new ones. Tony Stank. That is not a... What are we doing? Get out of here. Oh, Ganondorf. Ganondorf, I mean, that's... that you're... You know my interests. Negan from The Walking Dead is good. There's some good... We got some good ones in here. How about... Let's do Dr. Doom. I don't think I've ever drawn Dr. Doom, ever. I have never drawn Dr. Doom. Not that I can recall. Which reference do I use? I kind of want, like, classic. I want like classic Dr. Doom. Of course, I don't know what that means. Oh, do I dare? Do I dare? This is like Jack Kirby. Do I dare? I think I might dare. I'm gonna try to. We'll try to do. I've got a reference up from the. Looks like a. Oh, uh-oh. We're going into the upside down on this music. Just enough to make you feel slightly unsettled. Are you feeling slightly unsettled? Good. Weird. Let me move that over so I can see it a little bit better. So I've got this like really good shot. I don't know if it's, I don't think it's from the cover, Larry, but it's like a really good like headshot. And I'm gonna try to do this one. I was just reminded of your artwork, Larry. I have not forgotten. You might have forgotten, I have not forgotten. No, that has to like come out a lot more. It's got to bow out more. Like, now here. Kind of like, this music's unsettling. I don't want to keep messing with this. Just play the good stuff, right? Is it that hard? Just play the things I like. I'm gonna start with the hoodie, and then we're gonna work our way in. So, Ark. Tell me about this not okay day. Is there something weird going on? Or are you just, it's just a meh. It's just a meh day. Or is there something happening? What's going on? Okay, this is like a little darker on the bottom here. Action. I feel like I'm looking through a Marvel, how to draw a Marvel book right now. Which I have. I have How to Draw Comics the Marvel Way by Stan Lee and Jack Kirby. Which I've had since I was a child. Ark says, I got recommended a video about art AI again, and it's deeply disturbing to me. I've been messed up all day. Well, you know, the solution to that is to just don't ever take anyone's recommendations on anything. Problem solved. Just don't ever listen to anyone about anything. Easy. Got to get thinned out a little bit here. The computers are coming for us all. It was in my YouTube feed. Why did I click? Oh, see? Definitely don't trust YouTube. Of all the things to not trust, don't trust them. I got a message from Facebook/Meta that like made me so mad. It went off. I was so angry. I mean, it was just a dumb normal marketing message, but it just, I went off. It was like,
It wasn't even personalized. It was just like a marketing message to my page, because it's a business page, my Facebook business page. And it was like, hey, congratulations on having so much engagement with your audience and having such an awesome fan base. Would you like to try to grow it? You should try. Have you, like it said, have you ever considered posting daily? And I'm like, I swear to God, I'm gonna throw my phone across the house.
We'll just put one in here by the cat.
Yes. We'll just don't go around.
Yes, I think so. Yes, the joyfulness is over.
The joyfulness is over. We can only hope they are benevolent overlord. Yes, Bubble Levo. Quality is crazy. Yeah, it is. I hate being a doomer. Yeah, don't be a doomer. Okay, doomer. All right, I'm gonna do another layer for the. I'm starting like the little cape thing. I don't want to mess that up. I like on this image that I'm looking at, the reference, where it's like the circle is absolutely perfect. And it's like totally a different line weight than the rest of the art. Like it's clearly there was a tool used, which is fine. I mean, there's nothing wrong with that, but it's funny because it's like not even the same line weight as the rest of the artwork. It's like obviously different. I don't know. I hope we can still keep doing what we do. Oh yeah, it'll be fine, man. Don't worry about it. Don't worry about those robots. Don't worry about the robots, man. Okay, that's probably fine. Whatever you do, don't worry about the robots. It's so funny how, like, this is definitely not, like, modern-day comic art. It's interesting. The reference, that is, not necessarily my drawing. Okay, another one. And another one. Okay. One thing I really do like, I love the Kirby cackle, right? Or Kirby crackle? What is it? Crackle or cackle? Where it's like the energy. He like the way he draws like energy. I can't remember if it's crackle or cackle. But it's like, I love it. It's really, really cool. I did that on my Spider-Man, that Spider-Man drawing that I did, where it's the three different Spider-Men on the cover, I purposefully put that in behind them. I'm sure he had a cackle too. He probably did. Is it crackle, the Kirby crackle? Yeah, that makes sense. The big plus side is apparently you can't copyright AI work. So maybe we say, yeah, it's a computer, you can't copyright. See, it'll be fine, man. Don't worry about it. All right, we need... This, like, rope is also kind of weird. It's like trying to be, like, twisted, but it's not really drawn in a way that makes me think it's twisted. Not to critique a master, but it, like, it's kind of... So I'm adding... these lines, these extra lines, I have added them. They are not there in the reference. Forgive me. Pardon me for this travesty. Okay, we'll do that. We'll do that. We got lots of little lines going on all over the place. Every line, here's a line, there's a line, everybody gets a line. Okay. Are we ready for the main event? For the main event? Bobo Lavo says, Arctic Arts, you will get all the marketing gigs still. Yeah, I think that like being a personality with an art brand will be the future, which thankfully is what we do. People will connect with the human element, for sure. For sure. All right, I guess I'll draw the real face. All right, let's merge these together. New layer. Unless you guys wanted me to stay with that. You liked that edit. You liked that version of Dr. Doom more. He's not very Doom, he's very happy. He's a happy guy. He's a happy, happy Doom. This like is basically all dark. And this is two. Yeah, I'm just on that copium right now. Scary, stupid, scary robots. Everybody, let's show Arctic Arts how robots are not scary, and let's spam as many robots as you can on the screen. I will start you off. Look at all these robots. Look at all the give Arctic Arts the robots and show him that they're not to be scary. Please don't fail me. please don't do this. Not like this. Thank you, Ray. Thank you. We got some robots. Thank you. Bobo Lavo says, Arctic Arts and people are also bad at explaining what they want. It's easier for an artist to get reasonable art out of an AI because they know how to describe things. For most people, it's hard for serious work. Like, I want Barbiecore Sonic, the AI might get it. But I need a friendly symbol that is easy to reproduce and not too similar to someone else's heart. That's all fair. That is totally fair. We need to do like some of this action here. Thank you, Bubble Love. Thank you. Okay. I remember reading something that another comic artist, like a modern comic artist, had written on, I think, Twitter about how he had gone back and looked at some of the Jack Kirby stuff, and he was like, he goes, man, do I love this stuff, but the shading makes no sense. But he's like, but only Jack Kirby could do this and make it work, but no, the shading makes no sense on any of this. Like, where even is the light source? And I thought that was funny. Okay, there's just one more at the end. It's like that.
Also true, the consumer-facing element. I had a commission where someone wanted a character, but they only have, like, the type of idea or genre, and I kind of fill in the design gaps. Where's the light source? Yes, that is a weird question mark. It is a weird question mark. Larry says, Jack Kirby was drawing before they invented light. That's true. Dr. Doom is looking good so far. Thank you, Hawkeye Lego Man. Appreciate it. All right, let's do the nose. He's looking down, just so you guys know. He's like looking down at you. As Dr. Doom would do. He's like not impressed by you. Okay, we got one there. We got this little squiggly. Okay. Got like a cheekbone. And also here too. Okay. But yeah, I hope one day I would like to be at a place where I can be a little bit more selective in what shows I go to and travel around a little bit more, like maybe focus on just the big ones. That would be cool. I'm not anywhere near there right now. I gotta stick locally to me and yeah. And yeah, that's it. That is all. That's the end of that statement. Okay, Legoman says, oh yes, it is a key thing about him, I feel. All I remember is he wanted to be on the higher... Yeah, looking down. There's a lot of shots of him, like, looking down. Was drawing before they invented light sources. That was a good one, Larry. Larry got a zinger. Some more of these lines, some of these, and some of these. A little SpongeBob reference. A little SpongeBob reference for you guys. That's it, I believe, for what I want to do. Maybe make his nose a little sharper on the end. But yeah, I think that's pretty much it. Very good suggestion. Let's color this. Let's color this. How about some color, stupid? I literally said that, and then there you go. Dandy. Ho, ho, that's rich, I'll say. How about some colors, stupid? I literally, that's pretty great timing. Okay. That's a great idea. That's a great idea, Larry.
Wow. You did these?
I did.
Freehand?
Yes.
Yep.
I'm really proud of you.
Thank you, Pandy. Thank you so much. And thank you for the exclamation point book in the chat bubble of O. Appreciate that. Still live on Kickstarter.
Hi, Kevin.
What's up, Shy Guy Blogs? How you doing? Welcome to the stream. I'm drawing villains today. Today is about villains. So classic. So I guess, I mean, to really match the comic, right? There was no, like, I mean, at least in the reference that I'm looking at in, like, that era, there wasn't really, like, shading. They just used, like, the black tones for the shading. So I don't think I'll add shading. I think I'll just keep it with the, how it is. Let's see. You know what I'm talking about? Like, there wasn't, like, another, like, darker color. Like, it was just the one color, and then, like, black was the shading. Now we need silver. Ark says, I'm pretty hype on this. Dr. Doom is one of my... Is it really? That's awesome. What's up, B-Habs? Hey there. Sorry I'm 2 hours late. You know what? Unacceptable. Time to stop the whole stream. Guys, we have to stop everything. I'm sorry. It is quite all right. You are not late. You are fine. You know, you don't have to necessarily be here right at the start. That's the beauty of this. You can show up whenever you want to. So today is villains. We're drawing villains today. If you have a suggestion, you are more than welcome to put it in the suggestion box. I'm about to pick another one. Actually, right now, I'm going to pick another one. There we go. Dr. Doom is complete. I hope it's everything you hope for, Larry. All right. You go right there. Arctic Art says, yeah. I like that he occasionally is an anti-hero. Plus his range of powers is nutty. Dun, dun, dun. Yes. Well done, sir. Thank you. Hawkeye Legolas is classic. Good theme. Yes, today's theme is sponsored by Joseph Zawada. So, exclamation point Patreon. My patrons get to pick the themes of the episodes. So, Joseph Zawada has selected villains. I'm glad you like it, though. I do, too. Oh, This was Hawkeye Lego Man's idea. This was not Larry's suggestion. I'm sorry, Hawkeye Lego Man. Hawkeye Lego Man's the one that said Dr. Doom. I don't know why. I automatically assume Larry is with anything comic related. My sincere apologies. I hope it's everything you hope for, Hawkeye Lego Man. Here I am just like giving Larry credit for something he didn't even suggest. Oh, man. Okay.
Let's pick another one. I'm diving into the suggestion box. Let's see what we got. Let me look up a couple more of these, because again, I have no idea what they are. Interesting. Okay. Let me look up some more of these. Pay no attention to me. I'm just looking up your suggestions. How dare you, Bobo Lavo? How dare you put a horse in there? I did not know that's what was going to come up when I searched that. Let's see. Let me look it up. Let's see what we got. That's a good one. Got a lot of good ones in here. What is this? Some of these are crazy. What is this? What is Ray saying? Oh, who is this? I mean, that's a pretty cool design, so I'm game. All right, I'm gonna do this one from Ray next. Lord Dominator from Wander Over Yonder. Never even heard of this. I have no idea what this is. B-Habs has got a good one. Nice. Good. Good. I was trying to think out of the box. I was like, yeah, no, it's good. It's a fabulous horse film. Save it for the horse stream. Matt's already making me do another entire episode based on horses. We're already having to do that, okay? It's already in the works. Why continue the torture all the time? I mean, I guess I know the answer to that. And don't forget, those of you guys that are watching, remember, oh, there it is.
Yummy, yummy, looks so good.
Oh my goodness.
Looks so good.
That's so funny. Oh my goodness.
Looks so good. Yummy, yummy, looks so good.
What's up, Panda? That is so fun. I literally was going to say, don't forget that you guys get exposure bucks for watching. And you can use it to play funny clips, and you can even challenge me if you want. There's challenges that are in there if you want to spend your hard-earned exposure money. That's so funny. I was virtually, that's great. What's up, Panda? Welcome. That's so good. Perfect time.
It's probably the best drawing I've ever done.
They haven't even done anything yet. This is the best drawing I've ever done. See, now we have Panda and Pandy. We have full power. We are at maximum power now. Yes, this is. Oh, well then I guess I'm done. This is the best drawing I've ever done. It's great. It's perfect. Thank you so much. I quit when I'm ahead. Double Panda? Well, we have Panda and Pandy.
Looks so good. Yummy, yummy. Looks so good.
Hey.
Yummy, yummy. Looks so good. Yummy, yummy. Looks so good. Yummy, yummy. Looks so good.
The best part of that, guys, is you're going to see something different every time you watch it. I do. I love it. You see something, just something a little bit different every single time. Ark loves it. Don't let him make you think anything other than he absolutely loves it. Double panda alarm. All of a sudden, Yummy was blaring in my ear because my earbuds are on. It shouldn't be too bad. It shouldn't be like, I mean, it is a little bit louder than the other ones, but none of it should be like deafening. Shouldn't be deafening. If I have made an error and it is deafening, please tell me. It shouldn't be. I can hear it too when it plays, and it's not bad. For me, it's not bad. Okay, this is like mostly just black, so we just fill it in. I feel like this is probably going to be, it was not horrible, but I wasn't expecting it. That is fair. Larry says, gotta prepare for the next stream. Friday Night Bricks. Always an honor hanging with the great Kevin Hinkle. Have a great show. I'll be doing a show until tonight. Come check it out. Have a joy-filled week. Thank you, Larry. Larry, always a pleasure to have you here. You're always welcome. Any Friday. Any Friday. Except next Friday. Except next Friday, because I'm not going to be here. Any other Friday, though. Have a good night. Have a good stream. Yourself. I feel like Ray, when I post this one, like, I have no idea who this character is, but I feel like this is gonna be one of those that, like, people are like, oh my goodness, you drew so and so, and it's like, yes. Yes, I did that for you. How did you know? I did that for you. It is fun though when people like can relate to this stuff and they get all excited. That's part of the reason I do it. The other part is surviving, paying bills, living. Pandy says, I know this character already. Oh, cool. She's got a great musical number. Oh, I honestly have never heard of this. Never heard of it. That doesn't mean I don't trust Ray. Unfortunately, I trust Ray too much. Even though he doesn't like those two awesome guys from Demon Slayer that are hilarious. Paying bills, surviving. Kevin, alive. Yes. Yes, please. Oh. There's some hair that, like, hangs out over. I did not draw that. Let's see. That's a good reason. Can't argue. A great musical number? Yeah. That's fair.
Okay. Can you see it? Is it coming together? Is it appearing before your eyes? Yes, yes it is. Good. Mission accomplished. All right, we gotta do the gigantic horns. So I think what I'm gonna do is move that there. We need some height. So I'm gonna move you here. Okay, and now we have some height. Now we have clearance. Also, I need to draw this heart on the armor. You know what's sad, Ray, is I was talking about, you know, a couple weeks ago how I was running through Gravity Falls for the first time, and I only watched like 2 episodes. That's it. I didn't go back to it. Not because I didn't want to, I just haven't. Which I'm sure is very disappointing for you to hear. It is a shame. It's not because I don't want to. I just haven't. Okay. It's a shame and it's shame. It's both. I feel like that's exaggerated, but also accurate. I feel like it's both. It is both exaggerated and accurate. Yes. Okay. Time to color. Time to activate color. What villain first popped in your head when this was decided the theme? For me, yeah, what did pop into my head when I was first looking at this? So I usually look like a week out to see kind of what's coming up. What is the first villain I think about? I think like Bowser comes to mind. So I think about Bowser. Thanos. Those are probably my immediate thoughts. think I'll keep this kind of like how it is again in the source, where there's not a lot of shading. It's very selective. It's like cell shading. BF says, okay, let's flip it. What's the first hero that comes out? Definitely Link. Link from Zelda is like the default hero. Immediately comes to mind as Link. He is the first hero. Gygus was not your first villain fake fan. Oh, man. You're right. I am a fake fan. What's wrong with me? I forgot about Gygus. You know what's funny is, like, I forget about Gygus a lot in terms of, like, the main enemy of Earthbound. I think more about, like, Pokey being the main enemy. Which he's just, like, brainwashed from Gygus, but I still think of him. Link is pretty iconic. He is the hero. He is the hero. He is a legendary hero who is reincarnated over and over and over again to be the hero. You know what I'm saying? He's the hero. Cool. There we go. We got another one. Look at this lineup. Look at this evil lineup. I mean, isn't Gygus kind of a victim too? Oh, are we going into the... We are diving into the deep philosophical meanings of Earthbound. I'm in. Oh, that's... B-Habs has a great one. Oh my goodness. Oh man, we must and we will. We must and we will. Insert evil laugh. Yeah, which what do I have? I have it, this guy. Here you go. We must and we will. When would I ever draw this otherwise? Like, when on earth would I ever, ever draw this otherwise? Ever. For any reason. That's the beauty of this. That's the beauty of this program. Thank you so much. You are very welcome. Thank you for being here. See, this is why more people should be here. You can chat with me. I mean, that's already the big selling point. I don't know what else you really need. But you can request stuff and I'll draw it for you. Sometimes it's even good. I mean, I try to make it good every time. But sometimes it's really good. Right? Sometimes it's really good. Sometimes not so good. Sometimes it's great. Are you not entertained? Like, for reals though, are you not entertained? It took me a couple minutes to think of one that isn't obvious. No, this is great. We really dug Prey. Yeah, I looked at what that was because I didn't understand I didn't get the reference. And admittedly, me looking it up didn't help me, but I was like, all right. No, not there. Let me just draw the mouth.
Time to let the class in. Well,
don't want to keep them waiting any longer.
I'm so excited about
welcome
it.
To art class.
Oh, isn't this cooking?
Wait a minute. Isn't this cooking? I'm sorry. If you thought this was cooking class, you've been duped. Hello. Thank you so much. TCMP4 for the raid. Party of nine. Hello. Hi. Welcome, everybody. Welcome to the stream. Nice to see so many new faces. Welcome to art class. We have come to invade. Very nice. Hello, Sari Cake. Bree is here. What's up, Bree? Thanks for the follow. Snailians. I think that's how you say it. Hi. Hi, guys. Nice to see you all. Welcome. My name's Kevin. I'm an artist. I draw things. Now you're up to speed.
Now you know everything there is to know. So we are drawing villains today. So every Friday,
I stream this program, what I call the Doodle Stream. These are just sketches, but I take requests, and I draw people's requests. And the only guardrail, as it were, is I pick a theme. So the theme today is villains. So we're drawing villains. Here, I'll show you what we've drawn already. You guys just got here. You have no idea what's going on. So here's some of the villains that we've drawn.
We don't make mistakes.
This is
we
true.
We have happy accidents.
We don't make mistakes, actually. We only have happy accidents here. So here's some of the villains that were drawn. So it you can see it kind of crosses the whole spectrum of genres from cartoon to realistic to comic and all that kind of stuff. I do have a suggestion box, so if you want to drop your suggestion in the suggestion box down, if you're on mobile, it'd be like where the little, you know, the little happy face thing is. You can see the orange box, or if you're on desktop, you can go to the about and throw it in there. And yeah, really nice of, thank you for the raid, and thanks for you guys popping in. It's really awesome of you guys. Don't forget, you can suggest something. Exactly. Funny Figs knows. And thanks to all my peeps for welcoming everybody in. You guys are awesome. How was the stream you guys were in? What were you guys doing? Something cooler.
Jack, I
take
want
it.
You to draw me like one of your French girls.
You got it right. I never take that suggestion.
Looks so good. Yummy, yummy. Looks so good.
Hey.
Yummy, yummy. Looks so good. Yummy, yummy. Looks so good. Yummy, yummy. Looks so good.
There's no better way to welcome people than with the panda alarm, actually, to be honest. To be fair, that is the best way. That is the best way to welcome people. But yeah, I'll have to check out your channel and see what you were up to. TCMP4. See what was going on. Check it out. If you have any questions at all, feel free to let me know. I would be more than happy to answer them.
I think I've improved on your methods a bit too. I employed some chiaroscuro shading.
I'll improve on your methods.
What?
That's Ray trying to improve on my methods, as always. As always. I hope you enjoy that, Ray. I really added that in your honor. I was thinking of you when that got added in. I'm like, you know who would really appreciate this, Ray?
Right there, Doodle. Any last words?
Yeah.
Ray would appreciate this. That's what I thought. I'm like, you know who will appreciate this? Raymond.
Oh, Jesus! Oh, God! Oh! Oh, Jesus! God! Oh, Mary, Mother of Jesus! Jesus of Nazareth!
So you'll see all my redeems. Like 99% of my redeems are art related because this is an art channel. I only do art, unfortunately. Or fortunately. Depends on who you are. So yes, I only do art. I stream on Fridays and Tuesdays. Fridays is this. This is the main event, as it were. This is where I take the requests and we do the doodle stream. And then Tuesday is just like working hours where I work on commissions, I work on prints, I work on whatever. And it's definitely a little bit more chill on the Tuesday one, too. Not that we don't have a good time. OMG, strong Pat and strong Seth. No one ever knows, though. I think it's my second favorite. Yeah, it's hard to beat the Oh Jesus, though. It is. It is super hard to beat that one. I love Homestar Runner. Draw Trogdor. I have drawn Trogdor. I have a sticker of Trogdor. You can purchase a sticker of my drawing of Trogdor right now. And you know what's funny? We drew that on the body parts episode. So we had an entire episode dedicated to body parts, which was Boba Laveau's suggestion. And admittedly, I thought it was going to be horrible. I was like, oh no, how can I successfully host a live stream?
It's probably the best drawing I've ever done.
Based on body parts. I was like prepared for all of the absolute worst. All of the absolute worst scenarios possible. And it actually was pretty good. It was very good. I apologize.
A little bit uncomfortable.
I know.
Relax, big guy. He's just doing this for his art. Right, Homer?
Oh, yeah. Art.
Ray, you have, like, how much exposure money do you have? How much exposure bucks do you have? Yeah, anybody new, if you're watching, you earn exposure bucks for watching me, because we're artists here, and we work for exposure. You are wealthy. You are wealthy, my friend. Kevin, where have I been? Living under a rock? I don't know. Where have you been? He is like the design. He is spitting fire. He's burninating things. Yes. Like, I didn't draw a thing for him to burninate, but he is burninating. Arctic Arts is an exposure millionaire. Boba Laveau has 52,000. Why don't you guys ever use them to like do it? Dude, are you waiting for something? What are you guys waiting for? Do I not have good enough redeems? Are you waiting for some like crazy, crazy wild thing to drop?
Looks so
yummy.
Looks so good.
Relax, big guy. He's just doing this for his art. Right, Homer?
Oh, yeah.
Art. Oh, my goodness. So funny. I don't think I ever even said what we're drawing. I would assume most of you can figure it out by now. Is there anybody who does not know what this is? Speak now for public shaming. No, speak now if you don't know what this, what I'm drawing.
I think I've improved on your methods a bit too. I employed some Kiara obscure shading and...
I'll improve on your methods!
What?
I need a more angry redeem, like something that expresses pure rage. But that's my... I mean, you can use the emote of me being purely angry. Are you saying that's not good enough for you? Is that what you're saying? See, there you go. All right, I need to shrink because I want to draw like half of his body, but I need more space for it. Oops. Don't do that. I don't know what that was, but don't do it. It's not disruptive enough. Oh. You angry? Never. No. I don't get angry. Ray gets angry. Ray's default emotion is anger. So basically, you need a clip of Brian yelling as a redeem. Oh, what did I do? I did something dumb. Yeah, see? What did we do? What is this? What did I do? Oh, that's what I did. That was weird. I hit some weird thing I didn't mean to hit, and it made it so I couldn't draw on that anymore. So we got... Yes, that would in fact be perfect. Brian yells at everyone, so we can find a clip of him yelling at you. That's probably not far off, to be honest. It could be done. It could happen. That is incorrect. Actually, that is incorrect. That should not be that way. It goes this way. I will have to edit, because I have to add the tie. The tie is very important.
Oh no!
Yes. Well timed. Oh, still waiting for my, oh yeah. That's awesome. Hello, Tim the Creator. Hello, hello indeed. How are you? Welcome. Oh, actually, we're only like 10 minutes away. Well, I'm sorry. I'm sorry to our raiding friends earlier. I don't think I'm going to have enough time to do another one today. I'm sorry. Hopefully, if any of you guys are still around, yeah, join me on another Friday. I was really hoping to do one of potentially someone. I didn't check the suggestion box, though, so I don't know. Maybe nobody suggested anything, so it doesn't even matter. But, yeah, we are going to be wrapping up here. I only stream for 3 hours. I don't have the strength for more than that. It's accurate enough for me. Nice. Nice. So we got the tie here. Tie's very important because there's burgers on it. It's very important.
That See, belongs in a museum!
Oh, thank you. Only three, I get, yeah. Well, you know, it's funny because if you look at, like Matt Elder, for example, who, you know, pops in, drops a horse command, runs away. When he streams, because he does art streams over on his YouTube channel, not consistently, though. I think it's been quite a while since his last one. He will stream for, like, 4 to 5 hours. I can't do that. I can't do it. Can't do that. I'm sorry. Can't be done. I've tried. I fall apart. I can't do it.
Wow. You did these?
I did.
Freehand?
Yeah.
Yep. I'm really proud.
Thank you. Thank you, Panda. That's funny. What a funny villain. In this, like, roster, what a funny villain. Okay. I that's what I love. I love it when we get, like when we did do the horse episode and I had a sawhorse. That was stellar. That was, like, world class. I love it when that happens so much. It's hilarious. Or, you know what's another really good example? Fire. So we had an episode and the theme was fire, and somebody suggested Bernie Sanders. And I was like, I don't know if that fits the theme. And they were like, dude, Kevin, feel the burn, Kevin. And I was like, you know what? You're right. Let's feel the burn. Let's get Bernie Sanders in there. I think it's so funny. Bubblevo says, there must be some part of the Angry Kevin Burger ad you could appropriate for any Angry Kevin redeem. He's got very rosy cheeks. They should probably just all be. And he got a very rosy nose, too. But yeah. But you see, this is what I'm saying, you know? We have a good time when, and I bring it up because we just announced another one. But when we do, like, the crossover streams, when I go over on Brian's channel and I basically do this, but it's usually even higher energy and very intense and lots of time challenges and lots of, high energy and, like, go as fast as you can and... Which is fun. I do enjoy it. But then I'm like, look at what you can experience if you pop over. And I do this every week. And it's not as intense. You know what I'm saying? You know what I mean? People don't want to, they don't want to come over. They don't want to migrate. They're just not going to do it. They want their concentrated Kevin time only in the Rix O'Brien sphere. Which is fine. Arctic Arts is pretty sure the Hamburglar is the evilest of the... Yeah, without a doubt. You're crossing over? Yeah, we are. It is going to be August 26th. Bolovo says, sorry, I'm going to miss your... Oh, that's a shame. Lots of Brian Young. Yes. I hope you don't plan to promote your book or anything. Yes, that would be terrible, wouldn't it? That would just be awful. That would just be the worst. That would just be the worst. I think that day is... No, it's not the last day. It's like a week until the last day of the campaign. It's like a week from. But we talked forever ago about wanting to do it like every quarter. That was kind of our plan. Once a quarter to do a crossover. And we do have a good time. Like I said, it'd be nice if more folks would traverse and hang. Oh, thanks, Bubble of O. T tier one sub for 9 whole months. You're too kind. You're too kind. Thank you. And on top of the Patreon, super supporter, super Hinkle fan. Appreciated. Appreciated. Much appreciated. Too kind. Oh, what did Ark? Oh, you were saying, you were responding to the him being the evilest. 9 months, and yet we will have to wait for month 10 for that gummy bouncer. You never know. There's always lots of opportunities. And you know for a fact you will get your entire episode full of gummies. So that's gonna happen. I feel like it sounds like it's not gonna be great, so it's probably gonna be great. That's what happens. I'm like, is that a great idea? It's probably gonna be one of the most well-received episodes in, like, that's what's gonna happen. Let's just be real. That's what's gonna happen. What if the Hamburglar is like a vegan activist? That's why he's a villain, you know? Checks out. What's gonna be tough on that day? The crossover days, I'm streaming too. Because it's a Friday, right? Yeah, I'm pretty sure it's a Friday. So it's like, it's going to be a day. That's going to be one of those back-to-back. If you know what I mean. It's going to be great. Yes, it is. That's exactly it. It's going to be. Kevin, you're going to do both? I mean, that's the plan. Is there a time? I don't think I even looked to see if there was a time. I should probably look. But the plan was to do both, yeah. To, like, roll over into his after mine. That was my plan, at least. I need to draw the burgers. We can make a list of before of things to irritate Mr. Sabe. Oh my goodness. Oh my goodness, this is hilarious. Alright, meat. 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 So let me just kind of flatten the bottom of it, though. A little bit. There. Are you proud of this? Do you feel accomplished? See, it's when I get these songs where it's like there's the whatever, the lyrics, that's when I know I'm like, it's probably not going to be good. It's probably not going to be good. Hold on. Where is the, oh, here we go. But yeah, usually when I hear someone talking, I'm like, it's going to be bad. Oh, where'd it go? Oh, come on. There we go. And it's going to stop again. Fantastic work. Well, thank you. What a great group of villains. Yes, let's... Oh, okay. Bolivar says you start there at 7. Okay, it's 7. What do I want to do? I'll have to think about it. I don't want to, like, not stream just because I'm streaming over there, because that is not helpful to me. That's not super helpful to what I'm trying to do. So maybe I will bump up earlier, maybe an hour earlier. What are we doing? What are we doing with this music? Come on. You good? You gonna play? Okay. I'll have to think about it. But okay, so we are here at the end of our show today. It's been 3 hours. Thank you guys, as always, for sticking with me. I'm gonna take you on a little tour, as it were, of what were the villains we drew today. We're gonna wrap up, and then we're gonna see who we can raid. I'm sure we'll find somebody. I'm sure we will find someone to raid and go share all the love and support to another artist out there doing the thing, struggling, just trying to make it work, because that's what we do. All right, today was all about villains. All right, Bubble of O says Brian can start here for a co-art stream, and when he tries to draw, and then you book. I mean, that's kind of funny watching him draw. Today was all about villains, so the theme was suggested by Joseph Zawada. So thank you, Joseph, for your ongoing patronage. It is very, very appreciated. And he got to choose the theme, so he chose villains. And I asked if he had a particular villain in mind that he wanted me to draw for him, and he said Yubaba from Spirited Away. So that is the first one of the day. Came out pretty good, I think. And then we've got Vecna from Stranger Things, the most recent season. This guy, Dr. Doofenshmirtz, probably said it wrong, from Phineas and Ferb. This character, Over Yonder, Wonder Over Yonder, Dominator, did I say that right? I'm just making it up. The Hamburglar, probably the scariest of the bunch. This character from Naruto. I don't remember any of the names. I'm terrible. I don't remember any of the names. This snake person. Snake guy.
Oh, Jesus! Oh, God! Oh, oh, Jesus! God! Oh, Mary, Mother of Jesus! Jesus of Nazareth!
Yes. Sorry, Ray. And we got Dr. Doom. Dr. Doom looks pretty good. It looks like it's straight out of a comic. I mean, that's what I was trying to do. I was looking directly at a comic reference, trying to match it. I feel like maybe the top here should be black, like that. Yeah. Okay. Sorry. That little bit was. It's like, I think maybe. So that's it. We got a good batch here. Yeah. We got a good batch.
Wow. You did these. Freehand?
I did.
Yep. I'm really proud.
Oh, I just realized that the username was Snailians. That's pretty awesome. I'm sorry. I didn't say that earlier. I think I probably mispronounced it, which is what I usually do. But Snailians is a pretty amazing username. Thank you for that follow earlier, Snailians. And again, thank you to the raid from TCMP4. That was really awesome. Really awesome of you guys. I missed an... Although that was days ago. Never mind. That was earlier. Also, before I go, remember, I got a Kickstarter live right now. Exclamation point book. This is my first book. It is live on Kickstarter right now. I think we're 65% funded. It is a collection of all of my live streaming art from the last 3 years, 3.5 years. So 2019 to the first half of 2022, over 1,000 doodles. And it is organized by theme. So, you know, stuff like food and animals and pop culture and anime and all that kind of stuff. But it is really important to me. I would love to see it happen, and it will not happen unless it gets funded through Kickstarter. Just because it is a big financial burden to make a book, if you didn't know. So if you'd like to check it out and you'd like to support it, I would really appreciate it. If you want to share it, share it with the masses. That would also be really, really, really helpful. So the link is right there for you in the chat if you'd like to check that out. Thank you, Hawkeye Lego Man. Thank you, B-Habs. And yes, Bubble of O, remember there's no stream next Friday. So and also there won't be a stream on Tuesday either. So I'll be away at summer camp. So there's no streaming next week at all. So Kevin will be gone next week, unfortunately. He'll be back on the 19th with Patreon blank suggested theme blank blank. Yeah, here, let me grab the list. I'll tell you. Hold on. Ark says he's gonna miss me. I'm gonna miss you too, Ark. It's only 1 week. Don't worry. Okay, so we did villains. Ray. So in 2 weeks, Ray, Funny Figs, you are up, and you wanted elements. So our theme is elements, like fire, water, ice. That is going to be our theme in 2 weeks from now. Sponsored by Funny Figs. BF is going to be Kevin-less all week. I know. I like organization. I am that person. Yes. Yes. Oh, also, let me show you, in case you didn't see it. Let me show you the artwork I drew at 2 a.m. last night. Oh my goodness. I really like it. I'm very torn because it was just a sketch, but I want to do something with this now. Like, I really want this as like a shirt design or something. But I would never be able to list it anywhere because it'd be cease and desist immediately. But it's a Wario sitting on Mario's throne. Did you know Mario had a throne? He did. Did you know Mario had a castle? He did. That's the stained glass window from inside Mario's castle, and that's his throne. I really like this. I kind of want to do something. I don't know what to do with it. But yeah, so, you know. Ray's been waiting for this one. Yes, hype, Ray. All the hype. So, all right. I just wanted to show that. Let me close it. That's enough of that. So let's head over to Twitch real quick. And thank you guys for all your suggestions. Everybody that made a suggestion, I'm sorry I couldn't draw them all. I always wish I can, but just not enough time. Not enough time in the day. All right, I'm gonna search the art category and see what we got going on here. I try to find someone who is a little lonely because artists deserve people to look at their artwork. And we have met some really cool artists over the year doing this. Let's see. Bear with me just a moment. If you do need to head out, it's all good. Thanks for being here. I appreciate it. What's with these people that just stream themselves sleeping? And why is it in the artist category? Is it art? Is this a contemporary art piece? Is this contemporary art? Is that what this is? There's a lot of people streaming art that are not English. Sorry, I don't want to take too long looking. Let's see what this is. I'm back, Artstream. He's working on like environments and houses and stuff. It looks like a Pokemon Center. All right, so Mr. Bonnie John, I've got you in my sights. You do not wish that there was time to draw the horse. Liar. How dare you? Don't call me out like that. All right, if you can stick around for just a minute, we are gonna raid. Let me set this up. Thank you guys, as always, for being here. You guys are awesome. I'm gonna raid Mr. Bonnie John, who appears to be working on something Pokemon related. He's drawing, looks like a Pokemon Center. And somebody wearing like, maybe like a Cubone, some armor, Cubone armor. So if you can stick around, say hello, drop a follow. I am sure he would appreciate it. I would appreciate it. Thank you guys so much for everything again. Have a wonderful rest of your night. Remember, no streams at all for me next week. So I will see you guys the week after on Tuesday, but I'll always be super active on social media. So if you're missing things, just head over to whatever is your favorite social media platform. I'll be there. I'll be posting something. You guys have a great rest of your night. Have a great weekend. Talk to you guys later.